Let's discuss the solution for our branch prediction performance quiz. The first thing we want to do is figure out how many cycles are we spending per iteration of this loop in the case where we are fetching nothing until we are sure what to fetch. There is a trick to this, which is when we fetch the addI here, we don't know if it is a branch, so we are not sure what to fetch in the next cycle. When the addI moves to the decode stage, at the end of that cycle, we know that it's not a branch. So actually, the addI costs us two cycles, one to fetch it, and then there is a pipeline bubble until we can decode it. Similarly, the add costs us two cycles, one to fetch it, one to be sure that it's not a branch. For a branch, we fetch it in one cycle, we decode it in the next cycle, we're still not sure what to fetch because now that we know it's a branch, we need to know whether it's taken or not. So the branch costs us three cycles. When the branch is in the ALU stage, we have two pipeline bubbles already because we wouldn't fetch anything yet. And only after that, we know what to fetch. So there are three cycles worth of branch and doing nothing before we can fetch the next instruction. So overall, we're spending seven cycles per iteration of this loop. Now, let's see what happens with the perfect predictor. With a perfect predictor, when we are fetching the add, we can perfectly predict that the next instruction to fetch is this second add. So we spend one cycle here, one cycle here, and with a perfect predictor, once we have fetched this branch, we magically know that we should be fetching this addI. So we spend one cycle here for a total of three cycles. So the speed up of having a perfect predictor in this case is 7 over 3, which is 2.33. So with a perfect predictor, we would have more than twice the performance that we're having when fetching nothing until we're sure what to fetch.